One of the oldest silly rules that people hand out about how to use the English language is the one about can and may. I'm sure you will recollect having heard of it somewhere. There was nothing about that in William Strunk's original 1918 version of The Elements of Style. But when E.B. White revised the book in 1959 to make the present edition, he added it. A line about can is not to be used as a substitute for may. What they're trying to get you not to do is use can in the sense of permission. Linguists call that kind of sense deontic. It has to do with what's right or what's permitted. These modal verbs like can and may also have epistemic senses. Those are to do with knowledge or belief. Both can and may have both of those. When you say, it can rain in the desert, you're using an epistemic sense. It means it's possible for it to rain. This sometimes happens. Situations are not unknown. And you can substitute may. When you say, you can go out, you're giving permission. And may has that permission possibility as well. You may go out. The only real difference between the two that's there in the actual facts of how people use them is that where can has a physical possibility reading, I can lift 180 pounds, may doesn't have it. Anyone who said, I may lift 180 pounds would be talking about the possibility that it might happen, but not claiming that they had the physical power. From the fact that only can has the physical ability meaning, it doesn't follow that you shouldn't use its deontic or epistemic meanings. And if you just read decent literature and look at how can is used, or look at any serious usage book that gives you examples, you'll see that it's the case. Nobody should tell you that you shouldn't use can for permission meanings. It's always been used that way. There's nothing wrong with it. Don't listen to the silliness.